Hey guys, what's going on? It's MassiveJoes Weekly.
WORD! You see what I did there? That was a MassiveJoes Weekly WORD transition into the hey guys. You like that?
That was a MassiveJoes mating call.
That's skill right there, man. Mm. Welcome to MassiveJoes Weekly WORD, episode 11. Double digits, man.
I'm not going to say the joke I was going to say about...
Mention double digits, knees gets all excited.
My ears prick up.
Interesting. This episode of Weekly WORD, the first double digit episode of Weekly WORD, well, actually the second, because 10 was technically double digits too.
Legs 11.
Zero isn't really a digit, if we're going to get all technical. Anyway, five topics of discussion, isn't it?
Let's try and pump through them. We got to
get this done under 10 minutes. The first one, price of supplements in Australia. Why are supplements in Australia, when compared to the US, so much more expensive?
Mm-hmm.
Topic two, the all new ProIce protein ice cream.
Mm-hmm.
Topic three, where the f*** is Defcon 1? Topic four, Fitx. Mm-hmm. Real quick, got to give you an update on where we're at with Fitx. And topic five...
Generation Iron screening.
Generation Iron, exclusive private advanced screening. Topic one, Nick, why are supplements so much more expensive in Australia than they are in the US, man?
So we're starting to get a bit of a following in America through YouTube, Instagram,
Facebook.
Obviously Facebook. Mate, we only get it through the YouTube channel. When we put up like raw reviews on MTS, when we put up videos about MTS, people say, guys, you're paying a fortune for MTS. In America,
a fortune for every supplement we review.
But even
because in the US, it's like 60% of the.
But
price
even they're saying, "Oh, look how don't get it through MassiveJoes. Look how greedy they are selling it for $90 a tub." Whereas in America, you can get it for $50, around $50 a tub.
Let's use MTS Whey as an example, right? So we sell this for $89.95. That's the retail price in Australia.
So and the retail price in America US, is about $50.
About $50. And a lot of people go, yeah, MassiveJoes is just, and all these other Australian retailers are making that $40 as profit straight in their pockets. Them some greedy mother.
100% profit there. Jesus, we'd love 100% GP, wouldn't we?
It'd be delicious. People would roll around in Beamers, Benz, Bentleys.
I'd have the M3 Beamer.
I don't know what I've had. Anyway, why are they? Where does that $90 go, Neve? So all you right. take your tub away. What are the expenses associated? How does it go from 50 to 90?
Well, you have to ship it here halfway around the world, first off.
How about before even that, you go with the Australian dollar, which at the moment...
Oh, yeah, go the Australian dollar. So it's what?
0.85 US dollars.
All right, so...
So that $50 is now $60 in Australian dollar terms. Then you got your shipping costs.
Shipping it here.
Per tub. Which, if you do the volumes we do via sea freight, is not that much, but
You would not air freight it.
No, nah, but it adds, too expensive. Let's say, another $3 to $4 per tub in sea freight costs.
Yep.
So that's now $63.
You need the import permits?
Import permits. Another, import permits are expensive as f***, man, in this country. So let's go another $3 to $4 per tub. So now you're up around $70 a tub.
Uh-huh.
Then you got your inspection fees when the government comes and inspects the product.
You don't want the government to come and inspect it, but they do anyway. So without even asking them to come and inspect, they'll say, we're going to come inspect this protein and then we're going to charge you for it.
Another $3 or $4 per tub. Mm. So now you're into your mid-70s.
The MTS Whey chocolate had to be relabeled.
Relabeled.
Because it, for some reason,
Didn't meet Australian regulations. Didn't have this warning on it, man. This disclaimer down here that it's a supplementary sports food not to be used by people under 15 or pregnant women. Because if you're under 15 or a pregnant woman and you eat this, apparently you drop dead.
Yeah, apparently.
Another few dollars per tub right there, plus a few dollars per tub. Let's go less than a dollar per tub to get somebody to relabel it by hand.
So you got time and money to relabel it.
Time and money.
Then you've got to pay for the warehouse to stock it.
Warehouse costs, because you can't order. We don't order them as people buy them. We order thousands of units at a time, man.
Warehouse.
You've got to put those thousands of units somewhere.
So you got to have the warehouse space.
Yep.
Got to pay for the rent.
Yep.
Electricity.
Yep. We've even got to cost price.
Yeah.
And then at some point, we do have to make some profit on it, guys, because we are in the supplement business and we got wages to pay, man.
We don't work for free, some of us.
Some of us don't. We pretty much would, let's be honest.
Let's be honest, we would.
We enjoy what we do.
So yeah, so once you do that, you got to pay the boys wages, got to pay...
Work cover.
Everything. Everything.
Tax, all kinds of stuff. Oh, and we forgot GST.
Oh, 10% GST.
10% GST on top of that. So you can very quickly see, as much as people would have you believe, we aren't making 100% GP on these products. I mean,
yeah, we'd love it to sell...
We're not making a whole lot of, at all.
We'd love to sell it for $50 a tub. Don't get us wrong.
That's right. But we just can't do it. We can't do it at all. And that, my friends, is the cost of doing business in Australia. That's why supplements are so damn expensive. Most expensive in the country in the world to do business in, apparently. Australia. With all of our crazy costs.
Yeah. All right, next one.
Topic two. ProIce protein ice cream,
so,
my man.
This week, we just got the new frozen...
Launched.
ProIce protein ice cream. So it comes in three flavors. Comes in your chocolate. It's melting in here. You've
got a little bit of
vanilla
condensation on that.
And strawberry. So it comes in three flavors. I'll give you the macros. So the chocolate has 177 calories per serve, 27.3 grams of protein, 0.7 grams of fat, that's 1 gram of carb, 0.2 grams of sugar.
Damn.
Also, all natural, gluten-free, no artificial colors or flavors with added probiotics.
And I might add, they are delicious, man.
They are.
I've had a few different protein ice creams in the past. A lot of them have made my stomach upset. But this new ProIce is delicious.
So all of them have 177 calories in it.
Look at the viewers, Nick.
I'm just checking quickly.
Yeah, but it's rude not to look at people when you're talking to them, man.
So they're all pretty similar. The main thing that changes...
Look at them in their eyeballs.
The main difference between the flavours is they've all got 177 calories. The main difference is the protein may increase or decrease by anywhere from 0.5 to 1 gram. Carbs may increase or decrease from 0.5 to 1 gram.
It's delicious. Unfortunately, we can't ship them because they would melt.
I will happily ship them to you.
But when they get there, they won't be protein ice cream. It'll be protein in a tub.
In your tote bag.
But you can get them at Massive Joe's HQ, Massive Joe's DC, and all of the other stores we're going to open at the end of this year.
That does have a freezer in it.
That do have freezers, and it is delicious. And especially in this ridiculous Australia.
Yeah, funny story. We just got the, we got them in on Monday. Tuesday here in Australia. Dernancourt, power blackout.
Yeah.
For 28 hours, as soon as we just got these freezers.
Almost had our protein ice cream, not protein ice cream.
No.
But it's delicious. Come and get it, man. Come give it a try. It's pretty unique.
You'll even get a free spoon.
Next topic of conversation, Nick. People want to know where Defcon 1 is, man. Our top selling product last week.
So,
finally knocked off OxyShred from EHP Labs.
All right,
number
so,
one selling product.
So,
Nick Minute.
You?
Out of stock.
You, Massive Joe.
Yes, mate.
Me, VG.
Yes, sir.
AKA Neve.
AKA
Matt Bullitt.
Owner of Platinum Labs.
Terry Pushy Cats.
Also owner of Platinum Labs.
Hit him up in our Facebook message. You asked for in our Facebook message.
What did they do to us, those two owners?
Hit him up. Us four. The four best friends anyone can have are all in a Facebook group together called Defcon Make Gains.
Defcon Make Gains. I came up with the name. Thank you very much.
You did. Hit him up and said, guys, need more. At this stage, we had plenty of Defcon watermelon left.
Yeah.
Hit him up and said, guys, need Defcon watermelon. Out of stock.
No. 12 units left.
No, that was pineapple. No, that was pineapple.
Oh, am I stuffing up?
Yeah.
Sorry, man.
Defcon pineapple. I said, I need some more. I said, didn't have any at the moment. They'll let us know when it comes in. No worries, no worries. Kept just selling Defcon watermelon. Had like 120 units of watermelon. Kept getting down. I'm like, guys, we've got 12 left. Send us some more watermelon. Nah, sorry. We've got 12 left.
Neck minute, out of stock. When are they going to be back in stock, man? People want to know.
End of next, this time next week, they're telling us.
Their tubs of Defcon are running low.
End of next week, they're telling us.
Which I'm going to call is going to be the end of the week after. So you're going to be out of stock for at least 2 weeks, man.
And we'll be back in stock.
And if people are looking for alternatives in the meantime, because they've got to get themselves their pre-workouts, man.
If you want your big energy hit, D-Stunner.
D-Stunner,
C4.
No,
I like
C4. Can't compare C4 to Defcon.
I do, mate.
Get out of town.
No, it's not going to be the same.
That's ridiculous.
It's not going to be the same.
If you're looking for a concentrated stim and you can't wait off 2 weeks until Defcon 1 comes back in because Matt Bullitt Lowe and Terry Pushy Cats have shat all over everybody in Australia's chest simultaneously. And let me tell you, I ain't even mad. I'm impressed.
No.
It's quite an effort to do that.
No, I'll tell you what.
In the meantime,
I'm going to tell you what's an effort.
If you want concentrated stims, you go either D-Stunner from Betancourt Nutrition, I want to tell do you even work for a stuff company?
I'm going to tell Matt Bullitt and Terry Pushycats, I am impressed that you f***ed up a company in 3 months. Congratulations.
Next topic of conversation, Neve, before you say something you might regret.
No, I wouldn't.
We do have a stand next to them at Fitx.
Yeah, Fitx. So MassiveJoes and Platinum Labs have a conjoined stand.
It's not a conjoined stand.
We're like conjoined twins.
We're not joined with them. There's a whole walkway in between us. We're next door neighbours at Fitx.
Mate, Terry, anyway, the Terry Pushy Cats has told me that we're next door neighbours.
We're next door neighbours, but we're not conjoined.
And Blackstone Labs as well.
Yes. Anyway, we're going to be at Fitx, man. March 7, 8, 9 in Melbourne. Melbourne Convention and Exhibition.
Talking about Pushycats.
But you already knew that.
Talking about Pushycats, Asher, TMJ sponsored athlete, we'll be competing.
Yeah.
So come over
Whole
there.
Crew's coming.
So come over there to check her out. When myself, what day is Asher competing on? So on Saturday, well, when she's not competing, I'm sure she'll be hanging around the TMJ stand.
Of course.
Saturday and Sunday, yeah. Asher will be at the stand, so come have a chat to her. Big Jacos will hopefully making a bit of an appearance.
Jake Nicolopoulos, man.
So you got you, me, we got Jerry.
We got Swalbait.
Jerry Jerome Rome.
Just aesthetic. The whole crew's coming, man. Come and see us, come and meet us, come and touch base. We may even have, I'm gonna call it next week. We're gonna have our first concept. We've already got our concept designs written up, but I'm hoping for like a 3D fly around thing that we can show the viewers.
I don't want to give away too many secrets at the moment, just Seth.
No.
But I've been saving pallets for the last 4 months and it's coming along quite well out there with the used pallets. I'm building our stand by hand.
Really? Is that why I'm waiting for the 3D model? Because he's going to draw one up
on paint.
With a crayon.
On paint, but I've almost put all the pallets together to make some kind of fort.
Anyway, hopefully next week for Weekly Word, we'll have a 3D concept that we can show the viewers at home, get you all a little bit more excited. If you ain't excited already about coming to see us at Fitx, the TMJ stand, going to blow minds, man. Do you know we've actually got the biggest, from a supplement retailer, we have the biggest stand in the entire expo. Yeah.
Yeah.
True story.
We've got 27 people to fit in the stand.
Yeah, it's going to be awesome.
And
anyway, last topic of discussion, something pretty cool, man. We just signed off on today.
Just signed off this morning. MassiveJoes has secured the South Australian
rights
to the premier advanced screening of Generation 9.
Generation 9.
So it's out in the cinemas on the Thursday.
Yeah.
We've got the premier screening, advanced screening on the Wednesday night. 7 p.m. Hoyts at Norwood.
March 12th. Yeah, it's going to be epic.
So it's the weekend after Fitx. What's that? Like 5 weeks away, I guess?
Yeah, 5 weeks away.
So hit up sales@massivejoes.com to register your interest. I'll hit you back with an email telling you what to do to secure your tickets. So register your interest.
Yeah.
Sales@massivejoes. I'll hit you back with a reply.
Yeah.
Telling you what to do, how to make payment, how to secure your spots.
But if you're interested, how much is it per ticket?
$15 per ticket.
$15 per ticket.
Or just come in store. Hit us up. Just come in store. Or if you want to pay online, hit me up at sales.
It's actually cheaper than going to the cinema.
It is.
We're selling tickets cheaper than the cinema. Plus, how did we do that?
Plus all the free...
How does that even work?
Plus, tell them
I
what...
I never even knew... How did you guys come up with that price? I didn't have anything to do with this. I think we're actually going to lose money on this. Stuff it. It's going to be good fun.
And what else are we giving away, though?
We got all kinds of stuff going on, man.
No, tell them.
What? What are we going to... You tell me.
I heard...
Like I said, I've had nothing to do with this. I just heard about it this morning. And I said, yeah, that's a good idea.
Hoyts don't actually know about it yet either, guys.
No, neither does Generation 9. Probably should have locked this down. No, it's all been confirmed. Email sales at MassiveJoes.com if you're interested. More details will be coming out and we'll be sure to release.
But I want to tell you,
Weekly Word.
I'm just going to tell you, there's going to be a few giveaways on the night.
Yeah, it's going to be cool. It's
like samples.
It's a really cool event. The spaces are limited because they can only fit a certain amount of people in the cinema. So if you are interested, man, you've got to hit sales@massivejoes.com on the quick. Quick as possible.
On the ASAP.
And we're going to finish this Weekly Word. We're going to do our outro as per usual. And then after the outro, keep watching because we're going to put the trailer to Generation 9 at the end of this video so you can check it out, get yourself all excited. After the trailer, hit sales@massivejoes.com, get your tickets. Got anything else you want to add, Neve? Before I tell the viewers, to hit the subscribe button. Subscribe to our YouTube channel, man. Stay up to date with all the latest editions of Massive Joe's Weekly Word. Stay tuned for the trailer. And guys, that is Massive Joe's Weekly Word, and I'm coming to you from MassiveJoes.com. Stay massive.
I think the main motivation for me with bodybuilding is knowing that there's no such thing as the perfect body. But I'm gonna chase it as hard as I can.
Myself as a bodybuilder should be someone constantly striving to be 1% better every day.
I'm covering every angle to be better than them.
I don't care what kind of scientific formulas or whatever it is you come up with, there's no substitute for hard, hard work.
The title of 2011 Mr. Olympia, Phil Heath!
There's a lot of people out there wondering, can he do it again?
What does it mean to be Mr. Olympia? Do you have to go to bed every night and say, am I fulfilling the task of being the best at what I do?
Phil Heath has had a lot of gifts.
He thinks that hard work is going to be talent.
Keep your gifts. I work hard. If anything, I like to be the guy that smiles, plays nicely, you know, but I'm trying to take your head off just like
we're the meatheads, we're the idiots. We're able to do something that 99.8% of the people on the earth can do, which is lose fat and gain muscle at the same time.
People go, oh, steroids. Man, nobody can do that. Like, it's not easy to do. People don't respect it. Like, oh, I can do that with steroids. No, you couldn't. No, you couldn't. You couldn't do what I do.
My physique that I bring to the Olympia this year, it's not the product of 3 months of hard work, it's the product of over 20 years of hard work.
Each man's body will represent years of focus and concentration.
Is there a limit to growth? You know, certainly there's a limit, but I don't know that we found it.
If you and Phil Heath are 100% on game day, who wins?
I'm not mentally ready.
I expect to be the last in this thing.
No matter how well you place at the last show, this is the one everybody remembers.
When you line up the best in the world, it's so easy to judge.
It'll be a great event.
If you want something you've never had before, you gotta be willing to do something you've never done before. And that's what I live by.